Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Syncfusion Vue DateTime Picker using the Vue CLI command and the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Calendars package. The Vue DateTime Picker is a lightweight and mobile-friendly component that allows end users to enter or select date and time values from a pop-up calendar and drop-down time list. I will show you how to configure this control along with a few of its basic features like setting specific date and time, formatting, range restriction, and mask support. Let me show you the application creation process. I'm going to create an application using the Vue CLI toolchain. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue, Node, and Vue class component. In the command prompt, run the command npm install global Vue CLI. I create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name, my Vue project. I navigate to the desired location and install the Vue class component library. Then, install the DateTime Picker package using the npm install Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Calendars command. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the component, navigate to the app.vue page and import the DateTime Picker plugin from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Calendars package and register this component plugin to Vue. By doing this, all the component's child directives are also globally registered. Then I add the EJS DateTime Picker tag to the template section and import the material theme styles into the style section to apply styles to the DateTime Picker component. Next, the Syncfusion license key must be registered. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Vue trial license. From 2022 Volume 1 release, a license key is mandatory in Vue projects to avoid license warning. I then run this project using the command npm run serve. As you can see, the output displays the DateTime Picker, and I can enter or select any date from its calendar pop-up and time from its drop-down. I can also show a hint in the input element of the DateTime Picker when no value is selected. Add the placeholder property and assign a value, choose a date and time. See here, the specified hint is now displayed in the input element. Next, I will show you how to select a specific date and time to be displayed so that the DateTime Picker pop-up highlights the date on initial load. Dates can be specified using the value property. In the data method, I define a variable, DateTime value, and assign a value to it. I then assign this variable to the value property. Check now, the specified DateTime value is displayed on the DateTime Picker input element and selected on calendar pop-up and drop-down time list. Now, let me show you how to restrict the DateTime value selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. In the data method, I declare a variable, minDateTime, and set a start date with time. Similarly, I define another variable, maxDateTime, and set it as the end date with time. Then, I assign these values to the corresponding min and max properties. Check now, I can select a date and time between September 19, 2022, 9 a.m. and September 23, 2022, 6 p.m. You can also use built-in mask support to enter a valid date and time. To use mask support, import the mask DateTime module from the EJ2 Vue Calendars package and inject it in the DateTime Picker array in the provide object. Then add the enable mask property and set its value to true. As you can see, I can enter a date and time based on the mask pattern. The mask is formed based on the default format of the current culture. Finally, I will show you how to apply a custom format to the date shown in the DateTime Picker. I add the format property and assign the custom DateTime format value. Add the step property to change the time interval and set its value to 60. See now in the DateTime Picker, the specified format is applied to the selected DateTime value. Time is displayed in the hours and minutes format without the AM/PM indicator. The step interval is set to a 24-hour format with 60-minute intervals. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Vue DateTime Picker component using the Vue CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.